Anyway, let's just talk about the products that I have in my shed and what I like to use. Yo mate, what up? Welcome to another lawn tip vid. Alrighty, so as I said, in today's video we're going to be looking at some products that I use on my lawn that's in the shed. I've got heaps of stuff, so I'll show you guys quite a bit of the stuff that I use, but let's have a look at the lawn first and tell you guys what's been going on, because when I did that top dressing video, that was actually, it's nearly 2 weeks ago now, actually 2 weeks of the day that I actually shot that video, so I've done a couple of things since I shot that video. Boys won this morning in the Champions League, if you don't follow soccer, or football, as I'd rather call it, don't worry about it. So, after that top dress, I put some new seed down. So there was a couple of thin areas after I top dressed, just because the day that I top dressed, it was a stinking hot day, and I burnt one or two patches. I'll just flip the camera around and show you. You
can see, so embarrassing. A bit of a burn patch just there, which I've seeded now. And another one, ooh, there's my shadow. Another one just here as well. So there's a couple throughout.
I mean, it's not really that bad, but I just thought, I've got the seed, I might as well oversow. So a pretty simple process. I'm not to explain exactly how I overseed and everything I did with it, and I'm not gonna show any shots. But if you wanna see any videos on overseeding, I've done a few videos, I'll link some in the description. But basically what I did is, so I overseeded on this existing lawn. So I didn't scalp it down or anything, I just overseeded over top. But 5 days prior to overseeding, I put down some plant growth regulator. A lot of people know it as Primo Max. So basically plant growth regulator just slows down your growth of your lawn. So I haven't cut it in, we're getting close to a week now. It's probably only grown, I'd say not probably at the most 10 mil. Let's get a tape measure and check actually. Right, tape measure, let's check it out.
Cool, 30 mil.
So as you can see, it's only grown 10 mil in 5 days, which is really, really good considering the amount of fertilizer and product this lawn actually has on it. So it's really slowed the growth up, which is good because I want that new grass seed to grow through and not actually be covered by the old grass. And when I go to cut it, I don't want it to be really long, so I have to use the rotting mower again. I just want to keep using that real mower. So I'll give you an example of some spots that have actually come up since I put that top dress down, and they're actually a little bit higher than the grass that I've put the plant growth regulator on. So let me show you.
I don't know how well you can tell in this light, but there's a patch just there. We'll get up close. That's a bit lighter green. That's some new growth that's come through.
So if you look here closely, there's heaps of new thin, it's really hard to see. Anyway, there's heaps of new thin little blades in amongst there, which have been able to come up because of that plant growth regulator. So this is gonna need a cut probably on Saturday. So some of that's some stuff that I seeded when we top dressed. Now the other stuff's probably 3 days behind. So on Saturday, I'll be mowing because it'll be ready for a snip. So you can actually with perennial ryegrass mow it at about day 10 to 15. If you've ever heard of the guy called the Lawn Geek, Simon Rice, on, I'll link his channel down below and also check out his Instagram and stuff. But he's done an overseed on his actual cooch or Bermuda as you guys call it in America. And he's got really good results with perennial ryegrass, and he mowed it at 8 days, which is nuts. But it's turned out all right, so it does the job, works well. Shouldn't be really walking on this lawn because, you know, it's got new seed on it, but risk it for the biscuit, boy. Anyway, let's go into the shed and show you guys what I've got going on in there.
Beauty.
Here is my collection. Alrighty, so I have like a squillion products behind me, but I'm gonna show you a couple of the basic ones that I really like to use on a regular basis and what I recommend to you guys. So let's start with some of my favorite stuff, the Plant Doctor range. So let's just grab some.
And another one.
Alrighty, so I won't show you everything that's in this range, but I'll show you my favorite ones out of the Plant Doctor stuff. So, Stimulizer is one that I came across recently. I did a video on this I don't even know how long ago, talking about how it helps with root rot and disease like that. Awesome one to have in your arsenal. It's got a bit of fulvic acid and a couple of other random, not random, sorry, that's the worst word to use. A couple of other products in there as well. Secret formula. They won't even tell me what's in it, but I tell you what, the results are awesome. And I like to actually pair this along when I do some liquid fert or I apply anything that is liquid based apart from like your fungicides, only because I haven't tested it. They say it does work with fungicides, but I just haven't tested it yet, to be honest. And I like to do with my seaweed secrets and that as well. Now my next favorite one, Activate Mate. So this is their liquid fertilizer. So really good to use on a monthly basis alongside your granular programs of fertilizer. I actually use this through the hotter months of the year, so I don't actually put down any granular products on my cool season lawn in summer because it stresses it out too much. So I jump back to liquid fertilizers. So the NPK ratio on this is... Where art thou? 14, 3, 11. So 14 of N, 3 of P, potassium, phosphorus, 11 of potassium, which is K. So yeah, really well balanced fertilizer, and it's just great. Now, when I use that as well, I always like to pair it along with my favorite. I'm saying favorite for every one of them, but I just really like these products. And I'm not getting paid to talk about this either. Seaweed secrets. So I've talked about this in a video as well. I talked about organic products that are great for your lawn. Seaweed secrets is awesome. I actually replaced this with sea salt because I get better results with this. And this also has some... fulvic acid in it as well. Just really good organic based products that aren't going to put stress on your lawn. You're not going to burn anything if you go to the right application rates, and even if you go a little bit over, you'll still be safe. And they're just healthy to build your microorganisms in your soil. Just build that better healthy soil, which I always talk about in videos, and I think it is really important for you guys to understand that and use products like these. Now if you're in America and you want something similar to this, I know the Lawn Care Nut has talked about that Green County Fertilizer stuff, I think it is. I don't really know. I'm not an American, so I'm not really sure what you guys use, but I think it's the next G products or something like that. They all have humic acid and fulvic acids and very similar products in their range as well. So check that out. Go check the Lawn Care Nut if you want to see what those products are and the similarities between these as well.
Alrighty, so what else have we got here? So this is my plant growth regulator. So we can see the active in it is Trinexapac ethyl. People just call it Trinex for short. Trinex, sorry. Now this is just a different trade name for it. It's also called Primo Max. So there's heaps of different products. This is just the one that I've got. But yeah,
next we've got some good old fungicide. Now I use Banamax. There is a lot of other products out there. This is great for a preventative though on disease. Now when you start cutting your turf really short like I am, especially with cool season grasses, you gotta be really careful with fungus disease, especially grey leaf spot with perennial ryegrass. You can get dollar spot and stuff as well. Brown patch is another issue if you have fescue and stuff like that. But if you're going shorter, you've really got to make sure you get on a fungicide program. So I've done a video also on Banamax before. I'll link that in the description. Check that out if you like. But if you're getting low cut turf, make sure you use a fungicide.
Yes, the good old Barricade, which you know I talk about all the time. My favorite pre-emergent. It's good stuff. Check out my video if you haven't seen it already on Barricade and other pre-emergents.
Alrighty, so down the bottom shelf we have my wetting agent, which is this Hydrolink Advance from Grove Glowing Solutions. See just here, guys there.
Glowing Solutions.
Yep, really good wetting agent. Love it, works well. It was cheaper getting it in 20 litres. We can only get it in 20 litres, but yeah, that'll last me a long time. Now next one is actually my liquid iron, or my iron chelate, as you guys know from an old video, but it's actually chelate. Pronounced chelate, not chelate. Anyway, so iron chelate. This stuff is really good for greening up your lawn. I actually paired that alongside my plant growth regulator as well when I did it, just to really keep some color in the lawn. And because sometimes when you use plant growth regulators, the first time you actually apply them, it can actually slowly yellow your lawn off. So quick tip, chuck down some liquid iron with it as well as a mix, or even some fertilizer if you like, and it'll stop that slight yellow off if you've never actually applied it before. But anyway, so this is all my stuff on my top shelf. So that's my insecticide. Talked about it before. Check the link in the description. Just some DSMA and some, I think it's MCPA in it. Yep, MCPA. So that's to hit the pass pale. Now, I don't really like using herbicides in the backyard, so I use this as a last resort, basically. Some glyphosate, which you guys know is Roundup. That brings back some memories. Flip it around, what have we got? Just got some power feed up the top there. That's about it, up the top there. Now let me show you what fertilizer I'm gonna be start using in the next growing season. Alright, so this is awesome fertilizer, Anderson's Nutri DG. Just some good stuff, Greens grade. Now the SGN basically means your prill size, so that is a really, really small prill size. Let me get some out. Please don't spill it. There you go, so look at that prill size. Tiny. So the reason I've actually got that product there, the greens grade stuff, is because, remember, I'm dropping my height of cut really low, and I want that to drop down into the soil quickly and not sit on top. So if I had what I used to use for fertilizer, the NutriPlus and that, which I still recommend, it actually would sit on top and wouldn't drop down properly. I really need to clean up my benches, eh? Look at that, what a mess. What a mess! Whoa, what a mess. Missing half of my spanners. Toolbox is open. Lid's not even on. What are you doing, mate? You're not a greenkeeper. That's in the wrong place. I do use other products as well. That's just what I've got at the moment and what I'm using right now. I do always seem to change products around, but I'll always show you guys on this channel what I'm using and what I recommend at the time as well and during the growing season. Remember, I always talk about cool season grass and warm season grass as well, not just the one, which, because otherwise it'd be frustrating if I talk about one. But yeah, that's about all that I've got in here at the moment, and I'll update you guys when I change. If you guys have any questions about all the products I use, feel free to ask me in the comments below. Just, you know, just ask me. I'll try to get to it. I'll try to get to most of the messages, so yeah, you know. But anyway, lawn's looking so good, hey. I'm so keen for this rest of this seed to germinate, for it to really, really thicken up and look magical. Well, you know, I'd say it looks pretty magical now, but it can always get better. Alrighty, well, thank you guys so much for watching. Now, like this video if you learned something new in there, or if you just, you know, you like my videos. Subscribe if you haven't already, and you have a good week. I should also sort out this situation just here as well, eh? There's weeds in there. Nah, man, doesn't matter. It's all natural. Let it be.